ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान् शृण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, इन् द लास्ट् क्लास् ऐ जस्ट् रेड् औट् द 8th मन्त्र एण्ड् आल्सो एक्स्प्लेन्ड् इट् explained the overall meaning of that mantra. We have to read the bhashyam. That mantra I will read again. Na narena varena prokta yesha suvigneyo bahudha chintyamanaha ananya prokte gatiratra nasti aniyan hyatarkiyam anupramanat. So the overall meaning is this atma, if bahudha chintyamanaha, which has been interpreted by various people in various ways, this is not suvigneya, it is not possible to comprehend it easily unless it is told by a competent teacher. Na narena avarena proktaha, if it is not by a competent teacher, it is not easily understood. Then ananya prokte gatiratra nasti, this has to be told by somebody who is in that brahmanishta, who is having that anubhava, who is having that anubhava that he is the brahman. So that gentleman, that sort of teacher has to tell you. And then aniyan hyatarkyam anupramanat, this is so subtle, this is subtler than an atom. So this is, and this is beyond tarka, that is beyond logic. So this shloka, this mantra, word by word I explained. We have to read the bhashyam now. Let us read. Nahi narena
manushyena avarena proktaha
avarena heenena prakruta buddhina
ityetaduktah
esha atma
yam tvam mam pruchasi.
Okay, avarena, this word avara also explained. Vara is something, somebody who is chosen. Avara is one who cannot be chosen, one who is inferior. Avarena narena proktaha. Proktaha means that which is told, that which is expounded. Because the subject matter is like that. Because the subject matter is so serious that the teacher has to first of all feel that he is Brahman. And he has to convey to the student that this man also is Brahman. Tattvamasi, he has to say, you are Brahman. So he should be able to say. And then he should say that a jnani, he is one man who goes beyond all this papa punya. A jnani goes beyond good and evil. Papa punya means good and evil. So when you convey such things, it cannot be conveyed by a person who has himself not understood it properly. And if it is wrongly conveyed to a student that, okay, your jnani is somebody who is away, who is beyond papam punyam, who is beyond all this good and evil, then that fellow may or may not understand Vedanta, but he may end up doing all evil deeds. That is also possible. So a teacher is one who has to see where the student is, what is the level of the student, and then he has to communicate to the student. In the last class, that is why I was saying that in olden days, that is why they were so much bothered about the adhikari, who is the person who is fit to take that thing. So a person has to be fit, that is the receiver has to be good, and the transmitter also has to be good. So because the subject matter is so serious. And then the teacher has to himself feel that he is not karta, he is not bhokta. So he should be in that stage. He can't say something in the class and then show a totally different or opposite behavior outside. So in the classroom he will say that I am karta, bhokta and whatnot. And then outside you go and you hanker for money, you hanker for something else, somebody's favor and whatnot. So if that is the type of teacher, he has not understood himself. He is not above fear, he is not above greed, he is not above parigraha, he is not above raga dvesha. So such a teacher cannot effectively communicate to the student. Now, so narena avarena manushyena avarena. Avara means inferior. Proktaha prakruta buddhina. Prakruta buddhi. Samskruta buddhi versus prakruta buddhi. Samskruta buddhi is a buddhi which has been purified, not urbane or sophisticated. Sanskrita does not mean sophisticated, but it is pure, clean, such a clean mind. It should be a very pure mind. Prakruta buddhi is something which is interested in all the worldly things. Prakruta buddhi. Prakruta means always interested in all worldly pursuits, always interested in your personal self, always interested in your various acquisitions and what not. So this is the type of buddhi, that is a prakruta buddhi, as against a samskruta buddhi. Shastrena samskruta buddhi, samskruta buddhi, that is the thing which we have seen. So prakruta buddhina ityeta duktaha yesha atma yantvam ma pruchasi. Then nahi sushtu samyak vigneyaha vijnatum shakyaha yasmat
bahudha
asti nasti karta akarta
shuddha ashuddha
अनेकधा चिंत्यमानः वादिभिः. अनेकधा मीन्स इन सेवरल वेज. बहुधा, एकधा, द्विविधा, बहुधा, यू नो द वर्ड द्विविधा, त्रिविधा. विधा मीन्स दट विधि, सो मेनी वेज. सो एकधा, बहुधा, द्विविधा, अनेकधा, बहुधा, सो लाइक दट. So this atma thing is not suvigneya. That suvigneya he is explaining. Sushtu samyak vigneyaha na samyak vignyatum shakyaha. It cannot be comprehended properly. It cannot be comprehended in a correct manner, in a correct perspective. Because yasmat means because bahudha means in several ways. Bahudha in several ways. That is what he is saying. Anekatha asti nasti. So there are several ways in which this ultimate thing has been speculated upon. So for example, Charvaka say there is nothing called God, so there is nasti. So somebody else say yes, there is something called asti. Then Tarkikas, they say only atoms are there. Vaisheshikas, they say atoms are there, and from the atoms only, because of various, I mean combinations of atoms, all these things, so this thing has emerged. And of course God is the person who by some unseen power he helps in creation of these bodies. So that is what the Tarkikas say. So like this, in many ways, Mimamsakas say a totally different thing. Mimamsakas say, okay, karma is what determines this creation. Because of this karma, because of the effect of this karma only, all this human body is created. And you have to do a particular karma and go to a particular loka. Whether God is there or not, it is immaterial. You do your karma and you will get your result. So that is almost a sort of godless ritualism which they believe. So that is another type. So in so many different ways the thinkers over a period of time have been thinking. So bahudha chintyamanaha. Chintyamanaha means that which has been comprehended, which is visualized, which is being speculated upon. Chinta. Chintanam means speculation. Chintanam is thinking. Speculation. Chintyamanaha, that which is being speculated. Vadi bhihi means by various people who indulge in argue, by various arguers, let us say. Vadi is somebody who argues. Vadam karoti iti vadi. So a person who is arguing, who is advocating, or so many advocates of so many philosophy, schools of philosophy have thought in this manner. Then
katham punaha
suvigneyaha ityuchyate
अनन्यप्रोक्ते
अनन्येना
अपृथक्दर्शिना आचार्येण प्रतिपाद्य ब्रह्मात्मभूतेना
प्रोक्तः उक्तः
आत्मनि गतिः
अनेकधा अस्ति नास्ति इत्यादि लक्षणा चिंता गतिः अत्र अस्मिन् आत्मनि नास्ति न विद्यते
सर्वविकल्प
गतिप्रत्यस्तमितत्वात् आत्मनः. वेरी गुड. So, katham punaha suvigneyaha. How is it easily comprehensible? So, what is this? Then, who has to tell? So, ananya prokte. This word also in the last class I explained. Na plus anya is ananya. Ananya, what is ananya? That is one who feels, one who realizes, not feels, one who realizes, one who has that experience that he is not different from the Supreme Brahman. That mantra also I explained in the last class. Anyaha asau, anyaha hamasmi, anyosavanyo hamasmi iti nasaveda, yatha pasurevam sadevanam. So that was the Brihadaranyaka shloka, which says that one who worships the deity, or one who worships any deity as he is different, I am different, anyaha asau, anyaha aham, anyosavanyo hamasmi iti nasaveda, he is a man who does not know. Yatha pashuhu evam sa devanam, he is bound to all these so-called deities as a pashu is bound by a rope. As one animal is bound by a rope, such a person who thinks that he is totally different, he is different and God is different, he is bound to that as a pashu. So that is what he says. So ananya proktaha. So he is having that feeling, he is having that understanding that he is the Brahman. So he is an ananya. So ananyena proktaha. Ananya proktaha means by something which has been told. Pra plus uktaha, which has been properly communicated. Pra is well, samyak. Pra plus uktaha, samyak, without any sort of confusion, proktaha. Apruthak darshina, ananya prokta is again, he says, ananyena means, he again explains, apruthak darshi. Pruthak darshi is, pruthak means separate. Pruthak is separate. Pruthak darshi is, who sees difference, who sees diversity, who sees dualism. Apruthak darshi means one who does not see dualism, one who sees only one. In Gita also we were saying, shunijaiva shvapakecha pandita samadarshinaha. So panditaha, jnanis, they see the same consciousness principle in everything. Whether it is a dog, whether it is an elephant, whether it is a Brahmin, whether it is a dog or whether it is a dog eater. In all these things, they see that sama, samatva, they see the same consciousness principle which is there in the whole universe. So, panditaha samadarsha, sama, the meaning of sama itself is Brahma there. So, this is ananya apruthak darshi. He is not seeing diversity, he is seeing unity. In fact, we always talk about unity in diversity. Hinduism, there is what is called in India, there is what is called unity in diversity. So, in fact, that idea of unity in diversity, you can see in our own philosophy, in our own Upanishadic philosophy, in our own Vedanta. Upanishad Vedanta, it basically gives you that idea only. Do not see diversity, do not see dual things. You see only unity. So, that is what it says. So, apurutak darshina acharyena pratipadya brahmatma bhutena. It also says, this gentleman, he is also brahmatma bhutaha. Pratipadya brahmatma bhutena means that which is going to be told. Pratipadya, pratipadyamana, that which is going to be propounded in this book. In that sort of Brahma, it is his own self. He is aware that it is this Brahma is my own self. So brahmatma bhutena, pratipadya brahmatma bhutena. One who is in that experience, he is nothing other than Brahman. And that Brahman which is going to be expounded or proposed in the, say, advocated in this book. Pratipadya brahmatma bhutena proktaha uktaha atmani gatihi. Here there are three or four meanings for this word gati given. In the last class I was explaining. Here gati means a confusion, a sort of vacillation. Gati, a sort of vacillation. Well, what is that vacillation? Anekadha, in several ways. Anekadha, asti nasti, whether it is there or not there. Whether it is asti, nasti, ityadi lakshana. So it is something which is of that nature. Ityadi lakshana means of this nature. Of the nature of, say, whether it is there or not. That sort of vacillation, that sort of confusion. Chinta, gatihi atra, asmin atmani. In this particular subject called atma, that sort of vacillation is not there. Nasti, navidyate. And sarva vikalpa gati pratyastami tattvad atmanaha. Atma is something where there is absolutely no vikalpa. There is no question of, so many types of thinking. Atma, vikalpa means so many alternative. Vikalpa actually means alternative. Sarva vikalpa gati pratyastamitatvat. All these alternatives are closed. All the alternatives are totally shut down in the case of Atman. Atma is one eternal principle. आत्मा इज वन ऑम्नी से वी शुड नॉट से ऑम्निशियंट और ऑम्निपोटेंट. ऑम्निपोटेंट एंड ऑम्निशियंट रेफर्स टू ए फंक्शनल गॉड. वी आर रेफरिंग टू, व्हेन वी आर रेफरिंग टू ब्रह्मन, इट वी शुड नॉट से इट इज ऑम्निशियंट. इट इज नॉलेज इटसेल्फ. इट इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ अवेयरनेस, दैट इज नॉलेज, दैट आर कॉन्शियसनेस एज वी कॉल इट. कॉन्शियसनेस इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अवेयरनेस. ऑम्निशियंट, what is omniscient? One who knows everything, omniscient. We say God is omniscient. We don't say Brahman is omniscient. Even this omniscient God derives that omniscience, principle of omniscience, from that Brahman. That supreme reality is nothing but existence and consciousness. So in that consciousness itself, this God is a functionary. God is some sort of say functionary for the purpose of cosmos. So this is something different. So here, sir, also when we are talking about that supreme thing, there is no question of any alternative. Sarva vikalpa pratyasamita tvat. Pratyasamita means all things are closed. Pratyasamita, astama, astamanam means astama, 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 surya astamayam, what is called sunset, sunset. So like that, astama, astamita tvat means all those options are totally closed. All those sort of diverse speculations, all these say different types of speculations, they are all ruled out. So that is the meaning here. So because Atma is one only, and there is no question of confusion, there is no question of any alternative thinking about it, so that is the meaning. Athava, he is going to give another meaning for this word Gati. So Gati, the one meaning given is there is no confusion, there is no vacillation. Then Athava means or else. Athava Swatma Bhute,
Swatma Bhute
Ananyasmin आत्मनि प्रोक्ते अनन्य प्रोक्ते अनन्य प्रोक्ते गति ही अत्र अन्य अवगति ही नास्ति ज्ञेयस्य अन्यस्य अभावात्. सो ही इज ऑल दिस वर्ड अनन्य प्रोक्ते इज इन व्हाट इज कॉल्ड सती सप्तमी. सती सप्तमी यू नो अनन्य प्रोक्ते सती. When it is told by somebody who is in that frame of mind, so that is Sati Saptami it is called. When it is told like that, Swatma Bhute, Swatma Bhuta, what is Swatma Bhuta? With that which is one's own self, Swa Atma Bhuta, that Brahman is one's own self. Swatma Bhute Ananyasmin Atmani Prokte. So Ananya, he is again explaining the Ananya Prokte word only. Ananyasmin Atmani Prokte Ananya Prokte. So when such a man who is having that experience that Atma is one's own self, then Gatihi, that is Atra Anya Avagatihi. Anya Avagati. Avagati means understanding. Anya Avagati means there is nothing else to know. Once you know this, there is nothing else to know. Because after knowing Brahman, you need not know various diverse things. Because all other diverse things are only appearances in this Brahman. Whatever this universe is, that is an appearance in this Brahman. Anya avagatihi. Avagati means understanding. Avagati is understanding. Anya avagati. Anya, that is understanding of anything different. There is one saying in Upanishad, Ekasmin vijnane sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati. That is, if you know one, you will know everything. That is what is Atma. In another Upanishad, I don't readily have that quotation. Ekasmin vijnate sarvam vijnatam bhavati. That is, if you know one thing, that is what is called Atma or Brahma, then everything else is known, automatically known, because all those things, all the other diversities, they are in that Atman only. That is it. So, anya avagatihi nasti gneyamanasya abhavat. Gneyamana, gneyasya anyasya abhavat. There is no anyaha gneyaha. Gneyasya anyasya abhava. Abhava means absence. Abhava is absence. Gneyasya anyasya abhavat means because there is nothing which has to be known, nothing else which has to be known. Anyasya gneyasya, nothing else which has to be known. Gneyam means? Gneyam, no, gneyam is not jnanam. Jnanam is knowledge, gneyam is something to be known. There are three things, jnanam, gneyam and gnata. Jnanam is knowledge, awareness, consciousness. Gneya is something which has to be known. Gnata is some knower. So that is it. So, gneyasya anyasya abhavat. Gneyam is something which has to be known. Then, gnanasya
hi esha
para nishtha
Paranishtha.
Yadatmaikatva vijnanam.
Yadatmaikatva vijnanam.
So what is the supreme thing which one has to aspire for? The supreme thing one has to aspire for according to Vedanta is that Atmaikatva vijnanam. That awareness. Jnanam and vijnanam, there is a slight difference. Jnanam is understanding. Vijnanam is, jnanam actually means knowledge. Vijnanam is assimilation as an understanding, that anubhava. Getting that knowledge into one's own experience. You say aham brahmasmi. Aham brahmasmi, I know at an intellectual level. But feeling it, realizing it and living it, that is called vijnanam. Visheshena jnanam. So that is jnana vijnana yoga. There is one chapter also in, what is this, Bhagavad Gita. Jnana vijnana, not, there are certain terms which are, which we are going to get in Gita. So this atmaikatva vijnanam is the thing which is the topmost goal, which is the highest goal for which a man aspires. That is the para nishtha. That is the highest state of awareness. Para means supreme. Nishtha, that state, that highest state, para nishtha, that is the highest state of awareness which man aspires for. Jnanasya hi, yesha, yesha para nishtha. This is the supreme level which is aspired for. What is it? Atmaikatva vijnanam, the awareness or understanding or anubhava, that one is not different from Atman, one is the same as that supreme Atman. So Atmaikatva vijnanam. So there is, once you know that, all other things, there is nothing else to be known, because all other things, they come under the drushya category. Once you know that you are that consciousness and existence, all other things, they become drushya. So that is it. Ataha, avagantavya abhavat,
avagantavya abhavat,
avagantavya
abhavat,
na gatihi,
na gatihi,
atra avashishyate,
atra avashishyate,
avagantavya abhavat. Avagati, I said, it is understanding. Avagantavyam means something which has to be known. Avagati is knowing. Avagantavyam is something which has to be known. Avagantavya abhavat means because of the absence of anything which has to be known. So that is a construction. Because of the absence of anything else to be known, that is na gatihi atra avashishyate. That gati means that anything, understanding anything else. So there is no nothing else to be understood. Gatihi atra avashishyate. So the line here in the mantra is ananya prokte gatihi atra nasti, means once atma is told by such a person, there is nothing else to be known. Gatihi atra nasti, there is nothing else to be known. So that is the second meaning. The third meaning he is going to give, samsara gatirva atra nasti,
atra nasti,
anyasya atmani prokte na antariyakatvat tad vijnana phalasya
mokshasya.
So samsara gatirva atra nasti. So here the gati, what is the meaning of gati? What is the root? Gam dhatu. The English word is go. English word go is related to this gum only, gum to go. So this gati means movement. Here, where is the gati? Samsara gati. Samsara gati means transmigration. This linga sharira or this subtle body going from body to body and body to body eternally. So that is that samsara gati. So here the third meaning given is samsara gatirva atra nasti ananya atmani prokte. When that non-different self, ananya atmani prokte, when that non-different self is taught, when that non-different self has been properly communicated, then this, there is this samsara gati is not there. Say, na antariyakatva tad vijnana phalasya mokshasya. Because then once that vijnana is there, that moksha or liberation is automatic. Once that vijnana is there, once that avagati is there, moksha is already there. Moksha is not some place to go. Moksha is a state of awareness. Moksha is not a new place, something like heaven or some other place to be attained. We have seen that moksha is something which is strange to you or apart from you. Moksha is within you. It is only that you have to realize, shaking off all your bonds, shaking off your ego, shaking off your various ragadvesha, etc., abandoning your ego, that itself is moksha. Moksha is liberation. Means what is liberation? Liberation from all types of shackles. liberation from all types of bondages. So that is what is moksha. Then na antariyakatvat tad vijnana phalasya mokshasya. Na antariyakatvat, because it is something not different. Antariyakatvat means that because it is not something different from that that moksha is not something different. It is not, there is no, absolutely no delay actually. There is no action, there is no delay in getting it. Then fourth meaning also he is giving. Athava prochyamana brahmatma bhutena acharyena.
Prochyamana brahmatma bhutena acharyena.
Proktaha
atmani
agatihi anavabodhaha.
Agatihi anavabodhaha.
Aparijnanam
atra nasti.
So he is, now we know what is called avagraha in Sanskrit. Avagraha is, A is the akara is understood. Suppose the mantra is ananya prokte gati ratra nasti. Suppose you read it jointly. Ananya prokte gati ratra nasti. Ananya prokte gati ratra nasti prokte. And a slight A is understood. That A is signified by a little some S type of thing, isn't it? Some in some books it is something like a 2, and in some other books it is something like an S. So it is that word, what does it signify? That is called, that symbol is called avagraha. Avagraha is an A which is implied there. It is also called akara prashlesha or avagraha, which is implied there. So ananya prokte gati ratra nasti. That is how we have to read. That slight A has to be indicated. Ananya prokte gati ratra nasti. We should not separate. Ananya prokte gati ratra nasti. If you say, that meaning will not come. Ananya prokte gati ratra nasti, some slight A has to be hinted. So if you read like that, because this is all the Upanishads, they are all Shruti only. Shruti parampara it has come. So it has sound which has been transmitted from father to son, from teacher to student, etc. So if you do not give any gap between ananya prokte and gatihi, then ananya prokte gati, which means like this, ananya prokte agatihi nasti. So you, that if this instead of gati, you have to read it as agati. Ananya prokte agati. So it is as per grammar only. It is as per grammar, it is as per chandas, it is as per normal rules of say Sanskrit. Athava, let's read.
Athava prochyamana.
Prochyamana brahmatma bhutena acharyena proktaha atmani. Let us read it.
Prochyamana
brahmatma bhutena acharyena.
Brahmatma bhutena acharyena.
Prokte atmani. Agatihi anavabodhaha. Aparijnanam atra nasti. So here the meaning of agati is anavabodha. Lack of understanding, na plus avabodha, anavabodha, lack of understanding, aparijnanam also is same. Parijnanam is properly understanding, aparijnanam is lack of proper understanding. So when prochyamana brahmatma bhutena acharyana prokte sati, once it has been communicated by an acharya who is in that state of brahma consciousness, then atmani, in that subject matter, atmani means in that subject matter, agatihi anavabodhaha aparijnanam atra nasti. So there is no question of any sort of lack of understanding. So there is this lack of understanding or improper comprehension will not arise. Agati means lack of understanding or improper understanding. Atra nasti. Is this line clear? Okay.
Bhavatyeva
avagatihi
tadvishaya
shrotuhu
tadasmiyaham
ityacharyasya eva. So just as in the case of an acharya, this man also will get an experience. Tad asmi aham means that I am. So that feeling he will get. Bhavatyeva, it will certainly happen. The language also, he says, bhavatyeva avagatihi. That sort of understanding will certainly happen. Bhavatyeva, eva means, that is to confirm, just to affirm rather. Bhavatyeva, it will certainly happen. अवगतिहि तद्विषय श्रोतुहु दट सॉर्ट फॉर द लिसनर आल्सो दट सॉर्ट ऑफ अवेयरनेस व्हाट इज दट अवेयरनेस तद अस्मि अहम् आई एम दट इति आचार्यस्य इव इत्यर्थः लाइक इन द केस ऑफ आचार्य द स्टूडेंट आल्सो विल हैव दट अवेयरनेस विल हैव दट अनुभव देन एवं सुविज्ञेय आत्मा आगमवता आचार्येण अनन्येन अनन्यतया प्रोक्तः सो एवं इन दिस मैनर सुविज्ञेयः आत्मा सो दिस आत्मा बिकम्स इजीली कॉम्प्रिहेंसिबल और कॉम्प्रिहेंड नॉट कॉम्प्रिहेंडेबल इट इज आई थिंक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिबल आगमवता आचार्येण बाय आचार्य हु इज आगमवान Agamavan is the word, Agamavata is the Tritiya. So, Atma becomes easily comprehensible or easily knowable, let us say, when it is told by an Acharya who is an Agamavan. What is Agamavan? Agama is Veda. One who has studied Veda properly, one who has followed all these instructions of the Veda, one who is disciplined in Veda. So, a person who is not disciplined himself, he will not be able to communicate to the student. Because this Atma Jnana is something which is a very delicate thing. Because it is saying that you are Brahman, it is saying that you are above Punya Papa. So a wrong person who gets this type of understanding, he will become he can become a criminal also. He can become a very enlightened criminal, let us say. What you call enlightened criminal, he can become an enlightened criminal saying that there is nothing Punya Papa, I can commit a murder and get away with that. So, this has to be taught to a person who is well-disciplined, one who is incapable of doing anything wrong, one who is in that proper, he has undergone all that rigorous self-discipline of Yamaniyama, etc. So, all these things have to be tested. So, Agamavata Acharyena Ananyataya Proktaha Suvignyayaha. So, he has to convey like that. Itaratha he Aniyan Anupramanadapi Sampadyata संपद्यते आत्मा अतर्क्यम् अतर्क्यः स्वबुद्ध्यभ्यूह्येन केवलेन तर्केण सो दिस वन्स इट इज टोल्ड इफ इट इज नॉट टोल्ड इतरथा मीन्स अदरवाइज ही बिकॉज अनियान अणुप्रमाणादपि सो इट बिकम्स मोर सटल देन एन एटम Atom is just anupramana, just as an example that a word anu is used. There is nothing to do with anuvada or anything. The word anu is used basically to denote that it is so subtle. This atma is the subject matter is so, difficult to understand, comprehend. So that is why it is called subtle. That is why the word anu has been used. So it becomes like that. Sampadyate means it becomes like that. Sampadyate. Anupramanadapi aniyan sampadyate. That is, it becomes subtler than an atom. Sampadyate is it becomes. Then atarkyam is what? Atarkyaha. Why this atarkyam has become atarkyaha? Atarkyam when you are talking with reference to Brahma. Atarkyaha when you talk about Atma, because Atma is a masculine word. Brahma is a neuter gender. So, atarkyam, atarkyaha, that which is beyond logic. Swabuddhyabhyuhena. Abhyuha is just speculation. Swabuddhyabhyuha means some speculation according to one's own, level of understanding. So, everybody starts visualizing Brahma according to his own level. Swabuddhyabhyuhena, kevalena, tarkyena. This mere logic, which is not bothering about Shruti, which is not bothering about Anubhava, because in Vedanta we accept three things: Shruti, Yukti and Anubhava. Shruti is the Veda Pramana. Shruti, you know what is Shruti? What is Shruti? Shruti is Veda. Yukti means logic, because Vedanta does not totally discard logic. Vedanta takes logic into account. It also says, you go beyond this mind and take into consideration your anubhava also. Anubhava means experience. Experience, after all, you are experiencing something. That experience also has to be taken into consideration. So, that is what Vedanta says. Shruti, Yukti, Anubhava. So, kevalena tarkena. You don't bother for Shruti. You don't bother for Anubhava. Kevala tarka you follow. So that is, Tarka is only a mental mind, it is a construct of the mind. So you can't depend on that alone. So that is what it says. Moreover, whatever knowledge, say the senses give, that is not adequate to comprehend the Supreme. Our senses, after all, they perceive some limited knowledge. So that is the meaning here. So kevalena tarkena, this is something atarkyaha. It is something which goes beyond this tarka. Then tarkyamanaha. तर्क्यमाणे अनुपरिमाणे केनचित् स्थापिते आत्मनि ततो ह्यनुतरम् अन्यो अभ्युहति. So suppose somebody says, yes, I have visualized this by sheer logic, I have established like this. Somebody who is able to do some better tarka, he will say, no, it is more subtler than this, it is something different. Somebody will say, no, it is something different. So tarka, there is no pratishtha. Pratishtha means there is no finality. So that is why there is a shloka, very famous shloka in Mahabharatam, in that Yaksha Prashnalu episode. That Yaksha Prashna episode, you must be knowing, where all these Pandavas, they get caught by that, not exactly caught, they go to a pond and then they drink water and they die, except Dharmaraja. Dharmaraja goes and then he was also about to take water, where that Yaksha puts a question to him. Then what is that? There is a question about what is Dharma. Then what is Dharma, what is Punyam, Papam, etc. Then there is a famous shloka which says, Tarkaha apratishtaha, Tarko pratishto srutayo vibhinnaha. Tarkaha apratishtaha means this logic is something which is apratishtha, where there is no finality to that. Some gentleman will come and argue and he will say, this is the logic. Somebody will say, no, you have missed the point, and then he will put forth another thing. So tarko pratishtaha srutayaha vibhinnaha. Even the shrutis, there is so much of diversity. Then naiko rushiryasya matam pramanam. There is not one single rushi whose matam we can take it as the supreme thing. Then dharmasya tattvam nihitam guhayam. And this dharmasya tattvam, what is good, what is bad, etc. If you say, then why he says naiko rushiryasya matam pramanam? If somebody who is considered as a sage in India will not be considered as a sage in Greece or in some other place, Italy. So there, in olden days also, like in India, there were so many other places, so many other speculators, so many other philosophers, so many other thinkers. So like that, what you consider good in a particular place may not be good in some other place. What you consider dharma or correct behavior in one place may not be correct behavior in some other place. So naiko rushiryasya matam pramanam dharmasya tattvam nihitam guhayam. So what is right and what is wrong is something which is there nihitam in buddhi guha. Nihitam guhayam. This guha, this cave called buddhi, this cave called antahkarana, this cave called conscience, let us say in English, sometimes we say conscience. Nihitam guhayam mahajano yena gatasya panthaha. All the good, a great man, whatever path a great man has gone, that is the pantha. You can say plural also, mahajana yena gatasya panthaha. All the good people, all the great people, whatever path they have taken, that is the right path. So this is good or bad is something which is there in your own conscience, it is told to you. So here, of course, why has it come? Tarkaha apratishtaha, because of that shloka has come. Tarka, this logic is something where there is no finality. So, tataha anutaram anyaha abhyuhati. Somebody establishes one limit, tataha anutaram anyaha abhyuhati. Anyaha means somebody else will come and say, tataha anyat. Then, tatopyanyaha anutamabhiti. So, tatopyanyaha. Another gentleman will come and say, no, this is not finality. Nahi kutarkasya nishtha kvachid vidyate. Kutarkasya kashchid api nishtha na vidyate. Kutarka. Kutarka means false logic. Kutarka. Ku means bad. Tarka is logic. Kutarkasya nishtha. Nishtha means finality. There is no question of finality. It goes on and on and on. Na kvachid vidyate. So that is the shloka mantra. Let us read the next mantra. नैषा तर्केण मतिरापनेया प्रोक्तान्येन इव सुज्ञानाय प्रेष्ठ अन्येन एव सुज्ञानाय प्रेष्ठ यां त्वमापस्यत्य धृतिर्बतासि त्वादृङ्नो भूयान्नचिकेतः प्रष्टा त्वादृङ्नो भूयात् नचिकेतः प्रष्टा त्वादृङ्नो भूयान्नचिकेतः प्रष्टा वेरी गुड ओके सो दिस अगेन ही इज टेलिंग अबाउट तर्क अगेन यम लॉर्ड यम ही इज सेइंग नैषा तर्केण मतिः आपनेय दिस पर्टिकुलर बुद्धि इज समथिंग विच कैनॉट बी गॉट बाय तर्क सो दि ओवरऑल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दि मंत्र इज लाइक दिस न एषा तर्केण मतिः आपनेय इदि सब्जेक्ट इज न एषा मतिः दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस वर्ड मति इज द सब्जेक्ट हियर मति मीन्स हियर प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वाट वी कॉल सम्यक दर्शन सम्यक दर्शन वी हैव कम अक्रॉस दट वर्ड सम्यक दर्शन दिस इज द राइट टाइप ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस कैनॉट बी अटेन्ड इफ इट इज स्टोर्ड बै समबडी अन्येनैव नरेण वरेण प्रोक्तः न सुविज्ञेयः दट इज वाट इज बीन सेड अनलेस इट हैज बीन टोल्ड प्रॉपरली बै अ प्रॉपर टीचर इट विल नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड प्रॉपरली यां त्वमापः यां बुद्धिं त्वमापः द बुद्धि आर प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग विच यू आर नाउ गेटिंग यां त्वमापः लॉर्ड यमा इज ऑलरेडी सेइंग आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू ही इज गोइंग टू से ऑफ कोर्स बट देन ही इज ऑलरेडी ही हैज गिवन दट वरम वंस ही हैज गिवन दट वरम इट इज एज गुड एज गिवन सो दट इज वाई ही सेज दिस बुद्धि विच आई हैव गिवन टू यू नाउ ऑफ कोर्स ही इज गोइंग टू से बट ही इज सेइंग आई हैव गिवन टू यू नाउ That is something which cannot be understood by mere logic. So the overall structure is like this. If you want to note also, you can note down. Yam buddhim tvam apaha. The third line says yam tvam apaha. Yam means that buddhi. Yam buddhim tvam apaha. That buddhi which you have attained. Na yesha tarkena apaneya. Yam matim tvam apaha. The words have to be reconstructed like this. Yam matim tvam apaha. That mati or that proper understanding which you have now got because of my grace. Na yesha tarkena apaneya. This cannot be got by mere logic. Prokta anyena iva sugnyanaya preshta. Preshta is the address. Preshta means, oh my dear, my dearest fellow, my dearest boy. Anyena prokta na sugnyanaya. Anyena prokta means if it is not, if it is told by somebody who is different from this prescribed type of teacher, na sugyanaya bhavati, it is not for good, proper understanding. Then, he is also complimenting the student. In the third line, yam tvamapaha, you remove, if you take it out, satya dhrutir bata asi. Bata is an exclamatory mark. Bata means, oh, how surprising, how commendable. Satya dhrutihi asi. Asi means you are. You are satya dhrutihi. You are a man of firm resolution. Satya dhruti. You are a man of right resolution. Satya is satyam, we know. Satyam is truth. Satya dhruti. Dhruti means is resolution, a resoluteness, let us say. You are very, very firm in getting what is the supreme. You are not satisfied with a lower thing. You have asked for that Brahma Vidya, which is much, much above all the lokas which I promised. Satya, that is why he says, Satya Dhrutir Batasi. You are a person with great, resolution, great firmness, such a resolve, great resolve, let us say, not resolution, great resolve. Then, Tvadrungno Bhuyat Nachiketah Prashta, He Nachiketah, Tvadrung naha bhuyat prashta. Tvadruk prashta. A questioner like you, a student like you. Prashta means pruchati iti prashta. Pruchati dhatu. One who pruchati, one who asks is a prashta. Tvadruk prashta. A person like you, a student like you, na tvadruk naha bhuyat. Hey, for me, let me get such a student like you. The teachers will be also, they will be fond of good students only. That is why there is a mantra in our Upanishad. What is that? Amayantu brahmacharina swaha. Have you heard this mantra? So the teacher, he prays. One of the prayers is Amayantu brahmacharina swaha. Vimayantu brahmacharina swaha. This all good brahmacharis, let them come to me. All good, so that I can propagate this Brahma Vidya. I can perpetuate, I can pass on this Brahma Vidya to people. So that is the desire of a teacher. The desire of a teacher is to get hold of a good student and transmit his knowledge. So that is it. So, Tvadrum no bhuyat nachiketa prashta. Hey nachiketa, Tvadruk prashta naha bhuyat. I wish I get a student like you. More students like you, maybe. Now he has already got one students. Let me have students like you. So that is the meaning. So I will again say the meaning. Na plus esha means this one. Esha is in strilinga. Esha buddhihi. Esha matihi. That mati has to be applied to na esha. Na esha matihi tarkena apaneya. It is not attainable by tarka. This yam tvam apaha, from the third line you can connect to this. So this buddhi which you have now got, it is cannot be got by tarka. Prokta anyenaiva sugnyanaya. Pranyenaiva na sugnyanaya bhavati. That is, if it is told by a different type of man, it will not be for proper understanding. You will not get proper understanding. And the third line again compliments or comments this boy. Satya dhrutir batasi. Oh, what should I say? Bata is exclamation, as I said. Oh, you are really commendable, a man of great resolve, a man of true resolve. Then Tvadrum no bhuyat nachiketaha prashta. Hey nachiketaha, Tvadruk prashta, a questioner like you, let me have such student like you. Okay, let us read the bhashyam. Ananya prokte
Atmani utpanna
Ya yam Agama pratipadya atma matihi Naisha
Tarkena
Swabudhyabhyuhamatrena
Apaneya
Naprapaniya Ityarthaha.
Ataha
is therefore Ananya Proktaha. We have come across this word earlier also. Ananya Proktaha means one who is not having that proper vision, one who is not having that non-dual vision, let us say, one who is not having that non-dual vision in what? Atmani Utpanna, one which is in one's own self. Ya yam, this buddhi which say if it is not told by that non-dual person, agama pratipadya atma matihi agamayana pratipadyamanam atma matihi, that is that brahmatma vijnanam, that non-dual vision which is being propounded by the Vedas. Agama pratipadya atma matihi, that non-dual vision which is being told by the Vedas, which is being propounded by the Vedas. This buddhi na yesha, now this one is not by tarka. Swabuddhya bhyuha matrena. This tarka is something which is a product of the mind, buddhya bhyuha. But there is something which is illumining the buddhi also. This tarka is something which is buddhya bhyuha, that is buddhya abhyuhitam. That is something which is product of the brain only. And then something which is beyond the brain is there. So that is why swabuddhya bhyuha matrena na apaneya. Apaneya is that which cannot be got. Apaneya, that which cannot be attained. Na apaneya, it is not to be attained. Na prapaniya ityarthaha. Prapaniya is again same thing, not to be attained. Na apanetavyava.
Na apanetavyava.
Na hatavya.
Na hatavya.
There is another meaning also which Shankaracharya is giving. Na apanetavya, na hatavya. It should not be unnecessarily lost. It should not be unnecessarily negated by all this kutarka. You see, if a right teacher is there, you are going to get Brahma Vidya. If you are using tarka only, you are unnecessarily going to spoil the show. That is the meaning. If you want to use a common word, it is unnecessarily this tarka is going to spoil the whole exercise. Tarka is going to say, what should we say? Hatavya. You should not be unnecessarily spoiled by this tarka. So that is the meaning here. Na apanetavya va na hatavya. Hatavya means it should not be lost. You should not lose it. That is, don't lose it by wasting time in logic. That is the meaning. You are going to unnecessarily lose it by wasting time on logic. Then tarkikohi anatmagnyah
swabuddhi parikalpitam
yatkinchideva kathayati. So this tarkikaha he means yasmat, because tarkikaha, what is he going to say? Anagamagnyah, this man who is not bothered about the scripture. Anagamagnyah. So earlier mantra we saw agamavata. He should be an agamavan. He should be somebody who knows the Shruti. So he is again explaining anagamagnyah. One who is not familiar with agama. He is not bothered about what Shruti says. He is only bothered about whatever is visible to his mind, whatever limited knowledge he is able to get by his mind and senses, he is using it, and then he wants to explain it away. So anagamagnyah swabuddhi parikalpitam yatkinchideva kathayati. So swabuddhi parikalpitam, that which has been concocted by one's own buddhi. Parikalpitam, something which has been concocted, something which has been created by one's own buddhi. Yatkinchideva, something which comes to his, yatkinchit means something which comes to his mind. Kathayati, he says,
ataha
yeyam agama prabhuta. Your book says prasuta.
Yes.
Prasuta or prabhuta?
Prasuta.
Both one and the same. Prabhuta also is born. Prasuta also is born. Agama prabhuta matihi. Anyenaiva. Agama abhijnena.
Agama abhijnena.
Acharyenaiva.
Acharyenaiva.
Tarkikat.
Tarkikat.
Prokta sati.
Prokta sati
sugnyanaya bhavati
he preshtha priyatama.
So he preshtha priyatama is the address. Oh my most dear fellow, priyatama. Priya is dear, priyatara is dearer, priyatama is dearest. So when you say priyatama, it is dearest. That is the meaning here. So atayevacha, therefore yeyam agama prabhuta matihi. Yeyam is ya iyam. This which. Ya iyam means this which. What is this? This knowledge. This knowledge which is anyenaiva agama abhignena acharyena. Once it is told by an agama abhigna acharya. So earlier we have rejected this naisha tarkena matirapaneya param. By tarka you will not get. Anyenaiva sugnyanaya. Anyenaiva means a non-tarka man. Earlier first line says, naisha tarkena dismatarka, tarka you dismiss. Prokta anyenaiva sugnyanaya bhavati. That is, a non-tarka man, if he says, it will be for good jnana. Isn't it? So that is what he is saying. Yeyam agama prabhuta. Your book says prasuta. It doesn't matter. Prasuta also means born. Prabhuta is also born. Born out of what? Agama. Agama, agamat prabhuta. Agama is Veda, Shruti. It is born out of that, Veda. That is because of proper understanding of Shruti. Only by understanding, proper understanding of Shruti, one gets knowledge of this particular Atma. Agama prabhuta matihi anyenaiva agama abhijnena acharyenaiva prokta sati. So, ata tarkikad anyaha. Anyenaiva means tarkikad anyenaiva. One who is different from a tarkika. So this thing which has been told, properly told, prokta, properly told by somebody, sugnyanaya bhavati, su plus jnanaya, that is proper understanding, bhavati he preshta he priyatama. So this line is clear, isn't it? So something which has been told by a non-tarka man, never go to a tarka man. Unfortunately, this tarka man, he is shunned by all people. This tarka man, even in literature, this Tarka man is shunned. Tarka man is somebody who cannot appreciate the nuances of literature, it says. In order to understand or appreciate the nuances of literature, one should be a Sahrudaya. One should be a person who is having that ability to say appreciate it, that ability to he will suspend his logic for some time and then he will appreciate the beauty. So in literature it is like that. But here, of course, logic is not totally dismissed. Logic you please have, but along with Shruti, along with your Anubhava. Anubhava after all should not be discounted. So that is what it says. Ka punaha sa tarka gamyamatihi.
Ka punaha sa tarka gamyamatihi.
Ityuchyate.
Ityuchyate.
What is that, say mati, what is that buddhi which is tarka agamya? Which is beyond this tarka. Tarka agamya means tarkena agamya, that which cannot be attained by tarka. What is that mati? What is that understanding which is beyond, which goes beyond tarka? Yam tvam matim.
Yam tvam matim.
Madvara prasadena apaha.
Madvara prasadena apaha.
Praptavanasi.
Praptavanasi.
So this knowledge, yam tvam, this knowledge which you have got by my vara prasadena. By my varaprasada, he is, of course, he is going to tell, but he says, mad varaprasadena praptavanasi, you have already got it. So once he has made a promise, okay, I am giving you 100 rupees, that is as good as given. So from that point of view, he is saying, yat yam tvam apaha, the third line in the mantra, yam tvam apaha means, apaha is praptavanasi, you have already got it. So that is what he says. Satya.
Satya
avitatha vishaya dhrutihi yasya
avitatha vishaya dhrutihi yasya
tava
tava
satvam satya dhrutihi
satvam satya dhrutihi.
So he is again complimenting the student, saying that he is satya dhruti. So I think we will stop it here because there is some slight urgent thing. We will continue this thing in the next class. There are only a couple of minutes. We will stop it here. Om Purna, this Satya Dhruti, explain it, there is nothing further, almost it is over. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.